Hello YouTube, welcome to another video. This one will be showing how to create your own in and out temperature monitor using an Arduino Uno, a couple of ST11s, it could be ST11s, ST15s, anything in that family, and also outputting the readings to a LCD screen using the I2C protocol. As you see in the picture there, I'm pointing out a few things. Up there is the SDA and SCL connectors. Down here are two pull-up resistors. And they are essential, I found out, because I was trying to get this sketch to work and just was giving me gobbledygook without those pull-up resistors. And I finally came across something on the internet that showed how to use those pull-ups. Anyway, and here you go. You see where to connect the screen to the Uno. Okay, so here is the SCL connecting there to that pin, and the SDA. And this was another trap for the unwary, because I did not, all the other sketches I saw were telling you to like use the analog pins down the bottom there. I think it was A4 and A5, and man, I couldn't get them to work, and took a bit of head scratching. There's those pull-up resistors that I was mentioned earlier, 10k ohms. That's between the data and the 5 volt line. And yeah, and without them, you'll get like minus 40 degrees Celsius and ridiculous sort of humidity figures. So yeah, put those in, and everything should be good. Just zooming back out here again. Just thought I'd quickly mention the intro showing what is actually a fake bootloader. It was a bit of folly on my part. I thought it was funny just to have it doing all this stuff. I thought it looked pretty cool. I will show you the code for this when we get to that, but you don't need it. And it does boot straight into this, what you see right there, you know, within like about 2 seconds. You don't have to have that stuff, but yeah, I thought it looked pretty good. Right, and moving along now. Alrighty, so here's the Arduino IDE with the script that I'm using. You can see it needs only 3 includes. Right here, that's it. So it's pretty light. It's most of it's pretty self-explanatory. You got your pin set here. Defining your pins. Serial monitor. You don't need this, but I left it in because for mine, I'm actually using it to log information back to a computer to graph it and whatnot. Here's this fake bootloader. Look, somebody who's a whiz kid at Arduino or probably even C++, who's a real programmer, would probably would have done this more eloquently, but. Yeah, look, I just basically, it's just writing out each line. It's all pretty simple, you know. So, I'll put 2 versions up. There'll be links in the description down below where you can get them from. And so you can have this one if you want, or you can use the other version without it, or you can just delete it out of there. You know, that's the beauty of this stuff. You can fiddle around, just and play about. Here we go. This is creating the variables. to reading those sensors into the variables, printing the stuff. It's all pretty well commented. This is a serial logging, and I've actually got something better, but we'll save that for another video another day. And I just wanted to show you, because get the example where I actually ripped most of this code out of. Where is it? It is down here. Where is it? Ah, oh, down a bit further. There we go. Let me bring that one in. Make it a little bit bigger. So yeah, this is basically how I started with it, but I changed the serial print to an LCD print and included the liquid crystal I squared C library. Got the address for that LCD. That's another big thing you got to do. Let's just undo that. I used a I squared C scanner to get that address, and I think there actually is one of them built in as well in the examples. So yeah, over here it looked a lot simpler, but it was this gave me a good starting point to work it out. And you'll see, like, you know, some of this code really hasn't changed that much. You know, we've got the these parts here still look identical. And so I just duplicated that there and put a 2 on the end for the for the dual ST11s. I don't know what else I can really say about this at the moment, but this is where I got the idea about that having that little bootloader thing that's got the starting up thing. I saw that and went, oh, that's a nifty little idea. So I took it a few steps further and went with all this stuff here. All right, so I think that's it, but I may add some more in if I remember that I've forgotten something, I'll come back and add some stuff in. Yeah, so here you go. You can see them up here. They're not labelled on the board, so that doesn't help you. But once you get the pinout view of the board, it all sort of falls into place. Anyway, this is probably going to morph into something a little bit bigger. We've got a backpack for it. As you saw earlier, it's still just all set up on a breadboard, and there is, you know, you could have paused that video and you could build it from going from that strip board in the fitting. So I'm going to leave it here for now, and there'll be a couple more videos in this series to come. All right. Thank you.